88.9 WERS, you're listening to Standing Room Only, your Boston home for the best of Broadway and beyond. I am your host, Fiddler on the Air, Sam Fiddler, that is. And we are in the live mix studio with the Greater Boston Stage Company's cast of She Loves Me. Welcome to the live mix studio, guys.
Thanks for having us.
All right, so right before we get into the wonderful, wonderful music that you guys have prepared for us today, we're going to go around the room and do some quick introductions. Come on right up, tell us your name and what you're doing for the show.
Hi, I'm Sam Seamock. I'm playing George.
I'm Jen Ellis, I'm playing Amalia.
I'm Brendan Callahan, I'm playing Arpad.
I am Elise Robbins, I am the director and choreographer of the show.
And I'm Matt Stern, the musical director.
All right, welcome to the live mix studio, guys. It's great to have you here. So we've got lots of music, and we've got a couple of questions I'll ask you to make sure that we have everyone listening and knowing about this show. You guys open on November 24th, you run through December 23rd. Box office for tickets, the number for that is 781-279-2200, or you can visit www.greaterbostonstage.org. So to start us off, we have Jen Ellis, who's playing Amalia, singing Vanilla Ice Cream from the Greater Boston Stage Company production of She Loves Me, whenever you're ready.
Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together you and I will laugh at last night someday. Ice cream. He brought me ice cream. Vanilla ice cream. Imagine that. And for the first time, we were together without a spat. Friendly, he was so friendly. That isn't like him. I'm simply stunned. Will wonders never cease? Will wonders never cease? It's been a most peculiar day. Will wonders never cease? Will wonders never cease? Oh, where was I? I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I will laugh at last night someday. I sat there waiting in that cafe and never guessing that you were fat. Oh, that you were near. You were outside looking bald. Oh, my. Dear friend. I am so sorry about last night. Last night, I was so nasty. Well, he deserved it, but even so, that George is not like this George. This is a new George that I don't know. Somehow, it all reminds me of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. For right before my eyes, a man that I despise has turned into a man I like. It's almost like a dream, and strange as it may seem, he came to offer me.
Boston legend Jennifer Ellis with Vanilla Ice Cream from the Greater Boston Stage Company production of She Loves Me. That was fantastic. And that was also musical director Matt Stern on the keys, returning once again to the live mix studio. So once again, we are here in the live mix studio with the cast director and musical director of She Loves Me, the Greater Boston Stage Company production. That show opens on November 24th, runs through the 23rd of December. You can get tickets on their website at www.greaterbostonstage.org. Now, we're also here with Elise Robbins, who is the show's director and choreographer.
Hi.
Tell us a little bit about the show and the Greater Boston Stage production of it.
So She Loves Me is a timeless love story. Mm-hmm. It's actually based on a play called Parfumerie, and we've seen it several times. The movie Shop Around the Corner and the movie You've Got Mail are both very similar stories. It's about two people who fall in love over a Lonely Hearts Club, writing letters to each other. And then they wind up in the same perfumery selling together. And we get to watch how their relationship blossoms, both in the shop and over the letters.
Something very theatrical in the common mistaken identity of musicals. Yes. Characters not meeting other characters or having other relationships with characters. And She Loves Me is no exception. So we're also here with Brendan Callahan, who is playing Arpad in She Loves Me. Welcome to the Live Mix Studio, Brendan.
Thank you.
So you'll be singing the song Try Me for us today. Mm-hmm. And tell us a little bit about the context of that song within the show.
So my character Arpad works at the perfumery and as a delivery boy. And in the song, he's trying to convince his boss and also father figure, Mr. Maritek, to hire him as a clerk.
Something I'm sure we can all universally relate to. Just asking for that raise. All right, without further ado, with Matt Stern on the keys, here's Brendan Callahan from the Greater Boston Stage Company production of She Loves Me with Try Me.
I have trained myself going shelf by shelf, and I know every item in the store, every tube, jar, box, bottle, carton, and container, where they are, what they cost, what they're for. Although it's something you have never thought about, Mr. Maritek, try me. You need a man who knows the business inside out, Mr. Maritek, try me. You need help or I'd have never spoken. And why break someone in when I'm already broken? In this emergency, I wouldn't let you down, Mr. Maritek, try me. Oh, I can see by the uncertain way you frown that you've asked yourself, why me? For first-class clerking and conscientious working, Mr. Maritek, why not try me? You wish to return this jar, madam, certainly right you are. Madam, you say it smells like a drowning cat. Oh, it does it that. At Maritek, madam, we claim with pride the customer must be satisfied. The customer must be satisfied. By the way, we have a special sale on autumn heather. Let me spray some on your hand. Here, we'll smell it together. It has the three elements of good perfume: attractive to the nose, invisible to the eye, and functional. My wife has used it time and again. It's very appealing to us men. I use it myself every now and then. Oh, Miss Ritter! Miss Ritter, that's 20 and 6 for the autumn heather, 8 and 3 for the cream, 32 even for that bottle of Mermaid's Dream, 1 and 3 for the eyebrow pencil, 9 for the large shampoo, and then for the jar you're bringing back, that's 4 and 2 for you. That's a total of 98 less 4 and 2 for the jar, out of 100. Cha-ching! Here's your change, 5 and 2. There you are, the biggest sale in several years, I believe. Thank you, madam. Please call again. Glad I can help. Here is my card. Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again. Madam, I would gladly grow a mustache if you'd like, Mr. Maritek. Try me. Oh, I would even think of giving up my bike, Mr. Maritek. Try me. For first-class clerking and conscientious working, Mr. Maritek, why not try me?
That was Brendan Callahan with Try Me from the Greater Boston Stage Company production of She Loves Me, live in the Live Mix Studio here on Standing Room Only. Nice job, Brendan. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
All right, so we have one more song we're going to be moving on to very shortly. But before we do, I wanted to take a minute to talk to Matt Stern, musical director, who you've been hearing
Hello.
On the keys for those past two songs. Welcome back to the Live Mix Studio, Matt.
Thanks, Sam.
So you're not only are you no stranger to the Live Mix Studio and pianos in general, you've probably had a score go across your music stand from every modern classic and contemporary composer that's being done in Boston right now.
And
so the music for She Loves Me, the music was by Jerry Bock and the lyrics by Sheldon Harnick. And they're known for shows like Fiddler on the Roof, The Apple Tree, And what is it? What is it about there as a talented music director and sort of connoisseur of Broadway show tunes? What is it about their style and their work and body of work and She Loves Me that makes them distinctive?
So what's really interesting is that they're most known, I think, for Fiddler on the Roof, and mm-hmm. then She Loves Me is probably a close second to that in terms of their big body of work. And before She Loves Me, they had been writing shows like Tenderloin and Fiorello that were a little much more experimental. Mm-hmm. And She Loves Me was 1963. They were working on Fiddler on the Roof. They tabled it because Jerome Robbins was unavailable for the production until later. And then they decided that they wanted to do something completely different. And I think that's something that they write a lot, is that every time they approach a new score, they want to do something completely different. And the interesting thing about She Loves Me is that the completely different thing that they settled upon was sort of the most cliche of Broadway love stories that you could ever come across on stage, right? And I think what they've really done with this score is, we talk a lot in rehearsals about how this show feels like a jewel box. And every single one of these songs is just an incredible, actable, really well-written, really deliciously musical song. Mm-hmm. My favorite sequence in the show is actually a lot of the songs we're hearing today in the studio. In Act Two, there's sort of this amazing, which was really quite forward-thinking for a book musical back then, mm-hmm. this amazing sequence of songs that aren't really interpolated by big, giant scenes. You go from Vanilla Ice Cream to She Loves Me, which we're about to hear, mm-hmm. to right onto Trip to the Library, right into Grand Knowing You. These sort of four really strong songs that just thread together mm-hmm. And move forward the action of the play. And I think that was really quite forward-thinking in 1963. And also a lot of their musical work in the score sort of reflects this Hungarian atmosphere, because the show takes place in 1930s in Hungary. Mm-hmm. So they've talked about, I mean, this is like boring music nerd stuff, but they've talked a lot about
that's how why we're
they
all
use,
here.
Like, yeah, exactly, right? They've talked a lot about how they use the interval of the sixth a lot in virtually every song in the show. A lot of the melodies end up on sixth. A lot of the chords involve these sixth figure that is really reflective of that time and place. And they also have a lot of these little chromatic turns, even in the vanilla, that kind of chromatic flavor adds a lot of the Hungarian element to the score. So it's quite smart, and all of these songs are really great gems of the musical theater canon that have made them timeless, as Elise said before, that I think we're really looking forward to bringing them to our audiences in a few short weeks. Couple short weeks,
yeah,
I guess,
short
right?
Weeks.
Couple
short,
oh my guys, goodness, couple short
good
weeks.
Segue. You guys opened on November 24th. That was Matt Stern from the Greater Boston Stage Company's production of She Loves Me, the musical director. Tell us a little bit about the music. Thank you so much. So we're going to move on to our final song of the morning. This one featuring Sam Seamock, an Emerson graduate himself.
Yeah, shout out.
Exactly. You're in the right place for it. So you're playing George, and you are going to be singing the title song, She Loves Me, which, as Matt said, is included in that sort of block of songs. It also includes Vanilla Ice Cream, which we heard from Jen Ellis. And tell us a little bit about the title song.
Well, yeah, so this happens right after Vanilla Ice Cream. And this is, you know, these two characters, George and Amalia, who have hated each other since they met, are starting to recognize this deep affection that they've secretly harbored for each other since they met. So this comes out of that.
Fantastic. All right, so with Matt Stern on the keys and Sam Seamock on the mic, here's She Loves Me, the title song from the Greater Boston Stage Company production.
Well, 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 well. Will wonders never cease? I didn't like her. Didn't like her, I couldn't stand her. Couldn't stand her, I wouldn't have her. I never knew her, but now I do. And I could, and I would, and I know. She loves me, and to my amazement, I love it, knowing that she loves me. She loves me, true, she doesn't show it. How could she, when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loathed me, but now today she likes me. And tomorrow, tomorrow, my teeth ache from the urge to touch her. I'm speechless, for I mustn't tell her. It's wrong now, but it won't be long now before my love discovers that she and I are lovers. Imagine how surprised she's bound to be. She loves me. She loves me. I love her. Isn't that a wonder? I wonder why I didn't want her. I want her, that's the thing that matters. And matters are improving daily. Yesterday I loathed her, but now today I love her. And tomorrow, tomorrow, I'm tingling, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling, what the hell does that mean? I'm freezing, that's because it's cold out. But still I'm incandescent, and like some adolescent, I'd like to scrawl on every wall I see. She loves me. She loves me.
Was Emerson graduate Sam Seamock with the title song from the Greater Boston Stage Company production of She Loves Me right here in the Live Mix studio. Thank you so much. That was amazing.
Thank you.
And thank you all so much for being here, for all the great music that you've shared with us today, the jewels from your jewel box that is She Loves Me. And that show opens on the 24th of November. You are not going to want to miss this one. Closes on the 23rd of December. For ticket information, you can visit www.greaterbostonstage.org or calling the box office during the week at 781-279-2200. Thank you all again so much for being here. You are listening to Standing Room Only. We are going to take you back to our regularly scheduled programming here on 88.9 and WERS.